I've had a weird few years.
Okay. Well, it's almost summertime in New York, which means millions of people will be hitting the streets to see what New York and the summer has to offer. Here, with some tips on what they should check out. Yeah, you guessed it. Our city correspondent, Stephon, here he is. My man. Hey, Stephon.
Hi.
What have you been up to, buddy?
Oh, the things these eyes have seen.
Yeah.
Now, Stephon, the summer means lots mm-hmm. of special events. Mm-hmm. What's a good venue for families looking to get together and celebrate?
If you're looking to celebrate the summer, I know just the place for you. New York's hottest club is Scampi. Illegally parked behind the Statue of Liberty, this hate speech haven is a creation of frat boy guru D-Bag Chopra. And this place has everything. Zip drives, gozers, Kesha. And guess who may drop by? Is it Ryan Seacrest? No. It's a drowned albino who looks like Axl Rose. Plus, for the kids, there's a special workshop where you can build a bear, but not the kind you think. So come by this weekend and check out a VIP section filled with turtlenecks.
Oh, I'm sorry, do you mean turtlenecks?
No. Turtlenecks, it's a thing when, like, fat guys have a beard, but only on their chin roll.
Stephon, look, I don't mean to cut you off, but that place just doesn't sound right.
But they even have a pack of roaming draggers.
Now, what are draggers?
It's a thing of when an old dog has short legs, but a long penis.
Now, New York has so many cultural events during mm-hmm. the summer months. Can you recommend just one of those?
Yes. If you want culture and you want it now, I've got the place for you. New York's hottest club is... written and directed by James L. Brooks.
Oh, come on.
This place has everything. Backpacks, sea lions, Ron Wood. A rental car filled with bottled water, my best friend Joel. Plus a special appearance by evil celebrity chef Wario Batali. He's just like his brother, except he doesn't wear Crocs.
All right, well, I can't wait to meet him. But Stephon, for people who want culture, like regular culture, like mm-hmm. theater, where can they go?
For that, try blindfolded theater group Shakespeare in the Dark. This year, they're performing the Scottish play.
Macbeth?
No, Jackbeth.
Oh, okay.
The story of a 7-foot-tall female bodybuilder. She's got the heart of gold and a voice as deep as the mighty Mississippi.
Well, she sounds like quite a woman.
I went to prom with her.
Oh, no. Stephon, I'm gonna do you a favor here. I'm gonna narrow it down. Why don't you tell us some spots people can go to for 4th of July?
Absolutely. If you wanna celebrate the 4th of July in style, New York's hottest club is
Hello.
So what? What place?
Hello.
Okay.
This place has everything. Raffies, Yeti cabs, pedicabs driven by Yetis.
Sure.
Slowpokes, a woman with nowhere to turn. Just for the 4th of July, they've got a special display of Jewish fireworks.
What are Jewish fireworks?
The ones that go pew. The whole thing is hosted by cross-dressing founding father Benjamin Franklin. And if there's a lightning storm, he'll tie a key to the end of it.
The end of his kite?
No, honey, not his kite. So this year, on America's birthday, give her what she really wants, a hearty salute and a human R2-D2.
And I'm sorry, for those of us who don't know, what is a human R2-D2?
It's a thing of when a midget on roller skates dials a speakerphone and you put a garbage can over their head.
I'm sorry, Stephon. I know I say this everywhere. Stephon. You can count me out, because I am taking my girlfriend to the beach, and I'd invite you, but there's only room for two in our convertible.
Fine. Guess I'll just eat poison till I die.
All right, fine. You can come. I'll make my girlfriend walk.
4th of July.
We'll celebrate with a bang. Wait, no, I meant...
Too late. You're doing it.
Stefan, everybody! Have a great summer! In New York, which means millions of tourists will be heading here to see what fun the Big Apple has to offer. Here with some tips on what they should check out is our city correspondent, Stefan.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Stefan.
Yeah, I know who you are. Okay, so Stefan, Halloween, always a big deal in New York. So why don't you tell us about some of the best spots for people to check out?
Yes, if you need to get a spot checked out, I know just the place for you. New York's hottest club is
Jelly Bones.
Located on the lower upper side, this random home invasion is the creation of legally drunk clothing designer Nick Nolte and Gabbana. As you walk in, you'll be handed a glass of champagne. Or is it piss? Needless to say, this place has everything. Slurpees, mushmouths, litter bugs, and don't worry about security, because it's guarded by an army of hobo cops.
Hobo cops.
Homeless robocops.
Okay, yeah. Look, Stefan, that sounds like kind of a heavy-duty scene. I was, you know, just looking for something more traditional. Mm. You know what? Maybe this would help keep it on track. Why don't you walk us through what you will do on Halloween?
What I do on Halloween? Starting when?
I don't know, let's say 7 at night.
7 p.m.
Yes.
Okay. So I wake up. I go home. Take a shower. Now my dog, Bark Ruffalo, probably hasn't eaten yet, so I need to feed him.
Yeah, but where will you go when you go out?
Oh, right. I'll tell you where. New York's hottest Halloween party is... located in an abandoned white fish factory in Little Israel. This place is gonna have everything. Ghosts, ghouls, goblins, my son. And on the dance floor, you'll find both guys from Wham wearing a two-man horse costume. Spoiler alert, they're both in the back. Plus, there's a special guest. Have you heard of Blackula, the Black Dracula?
Yes.
Well, they have a Jewish Dracula.
Oh, what's his name?
Sidney Applebaum.
Okay. Sidney Applebaum? Jewish Dracula.
For a healthy snack,
oh, that'll be good, yep.
Hit the bar and have some Frasians, raisins that look like Frasier. or try your luck with the human pinata.
And what is the human pinata?
It's that thing of when a Mexican midget eats a lot of candy and then he dances until he throws up.
You know, Stefan, I think midget is actually an outdated term.
Sorry, not midget. Fun size.
Okay. Stefan, I was looking for something more wholesome for Halloween.
Right.
You know,
right.
A haunted house or a place to hear ghost stories.
Oh, I know a story with a ghost in it.
Is it a Halloween-related story?
Yes'm.
Okay.
Can I have the lights down, please? Ooh. long, 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 long time ago, like, say, 6 minutes ago, there was once an old house, and in that house there lived an old gay man that people called Slimer.
Why did they call him Slimer?
Well, if you recall, in the film Ghostbusters, Slimer was able to hold, shall we say, multiple hot dogs in his mouth at one time.
Oh, I understand and stop. I understand and stop.
If you understood, you wouldn't want it to stop.
I do understand and I do want it to stop. I do understand and I do want it to stop.
Sorry.
I understand. You don't understand.
It's great. No, I fully understand.
Now, I know that you've tried your best, Stefan, and I just want to thank you for sharing those Halloween tips, buddy.
Wait, don't you want to hang out on Halloween?
You know what? I do. I'll pick you up at 7. Where do you live?
You know the Radio Shack at 23rd and 7th?
Yes.
I live in a garbage can.
Stefan, everybody! For Weekend Update, I'm Seth Meyers. Good night! After a long winter, spring hits New York in a couple of weeks, and with it will come millions of springtime tourists. Here with some tips on what they should check out is our city correspondent, Stefan! Stefan, it's been a while.
I know. This job writing for Smash is killing me.
Oh. Makes a lot of sense. So, Stefan, a lot of people are anxious to enjoy the city once the weather gets warm. What are some places folks should check out if they're looking for a spring outing?
If it's warm and you want to be outed, I know just the place for you. New York's hottest club is Mary. Opened in 1997 by missing Florida woman Lisa Martinez. This club is currently going 90 miles per hour down the West Side Highway. This place has everything. Charts, graphs, PowerPoint, a guy who still thinks Jamba Juice is good for you. And if you liked Russell Crowe in Les Miserables, you might want to hear Jasper the Gorilla pass a kidney stone.
This place sounds fancy.
It is. There's even a password. The last words of murdered blues legend, Sweet Willie Walker.
Oh, what were his last words?
My wallet! Yeah, right!
Stefan, maybe we should try to think, just if we could try to think a little more family-oriented, you know?
Yes,
a place
yes,
for
yes,
the
yes,
holidays.
Yes, 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 okay. Yes. Yes. I know just the place for you. New York's hottest club is...
Your mother and I are separating.
Don't be fooled by the charred Red Lobster sign out front. This club is a burned-down Red Lobster. It has everything.
Uh-huh.
A shake for breakfast,
yep.
A shake for lunch,
okay.
A sensible dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Those shoes that nurses wear. And you could dance the night away to the sounds of Donald Duck having a Vietnam nightmare.
What does that sound like? Dance the night away to that. Now, Stefan, spring break is coming up. Any tips for college kids coming to have a safe and fun spring break?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Safe and fun. If you're looking to get hurt and go completely insane, I have just a place for you. New York's hottest club is Selfie. Based on the novel Push by Sapphire. Club promoter Joseph Gordon Fisherman opened the Soho hotspot located in a haunted diaper. When it comes to spring break, this place has everything. Chutes, ladders, the outdoor concert from a Zoloft commercial. If that's not enough for you, you can hit the dance floor with a human fanny pack.
Now, for those of us who don't know, what is a human fanny pack?
It's that thing of when a midget hangs around your waist and holds your passport in his mouth.
Stefan, I don't know if this is what we're looking for.
Fine. Look, I have two questions. Will you spend spring break with me, and why not?
I can't. I'm taking my serious girlfriend to Mexico.
To kill her?
No!
Well, if you go with me, you can join my five-timers club.
What do I have to do five times?
For Weekend Update, I'm the future Mrs. Stefan Myers. Good night!
Good night! Well, it's almost summer in New York, which means billions of tourists will be heading to the city to see what the Big Apple has to offer. Here with some tips on what they should check out is our city correspondent, Stefan.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Stefan. How have you been?
Who's this?
This is my platonic work friend, Amy.
Oh, hey, thanks.
So, Stefan, summer's right around the corner. What places should people check out if they're headed to New York and looking to have a classic New York weekend?
If you're headed to NYC, the Big Apple, the city that never sleeps, the thriller in Manila, then I know just the place for you. New York's hottest club is Pants. Located on that fake street from Seinfeld. This bed-bugged bridal barn finally answers the question.
Y'all ready to play the feud?
This place has everything. Hopscotch, double dutch, oogie loves, sling and mesh bladder implants, the table from Charlie Rose. And this weekend, I'll be having my college reunion there.
Oh, wow. What university did you go to?
UTI. I even made the dean's list.
You did?
Yes. Dean Kane's list of homeboys not to mess with. Anyway, the bouncer is a king-size lesbian who looks like Phil Jackson. And the password is Scotty! And if that isn't enough for you, you can hit the dance floor with a room full of human magic eight balls.
And I'm sorry, Stefan, is a human magic eight ball?
It's that thing of when you ask a question, so you shake a midget until he says,
ask again later.
Stefan, I'm sorry, this just isn't what we're looking for.
You know what? You never respect me, Seth. I didn't want to do this here, but I've met someone else, and he's a lot like you, except he likes me for me, and we are getting married. Bye, Seth Myers.
Stefan, everybody, I'm sorry about that. A new study shows that the tree frogs in the Amazon have been known to...
Hey. Go to him.
It's too late.
It's never too late. Follow your heart.
God, no.
Anderson Cooper, 360.
Stefan, run. I will fend them off. It is too late for me, but I will...
Thanks.